This April 19th marks the 50th anniversary of Moore's Law. 3 years before co-founding Intel, Gordon Moore made a simple observation that has revolutionized the computing industry. It states the number of transistors incorporated on a computer chip will double every 2 years, resulting in increased computing power and devices that are faster, smaller, and lower cost. Gordon Moore didn't set out to make a law, he was just writing a magazine article. In 1965, the semiconductor engineer was asked by Electronics Magazine to submit an article for its 35th anniversary that would make predictions about the next 10 years. In his article, Moore predicted that engineers would keep shrinking transistors, resistors, and other components, doubling the number they could fit on a square of silicon every year or so. The computing industry has benefited directly from the chip industry's steady march. Every new chip is smaller than the one that came before it, and at least as powerful but less expensive to make. In 2015, transistor counts on Intel chips number in the billions. In his paper, Moore predicted 65,000 by 1975. But once the transistor size reaches the size of atom, it is not possible to reduce the size of transistor further. So we can say that the Moore's law is almost nearing its end. If fuel efficiency improved at the same rate as Moore's law, you could easily drive a car for your entire life on a single tank of gas. And if cars shrunk at the rate of transistors, today they would be the size of an ant. If house prices fell at the same rate as transistors, you could purchase a home for the price of a piece of candy. Moore's law is an aspiration, not a law of nature. It is made possible by an army of people pushing the fundamental laws of physics. Today, Intel factories produce over 10 billion transistors every second.
A wild extrapolation and said we're going to continue doubling every year. We're going to go from about 60 elements now to 60,000 in 10 years. I was just trying to get across the point that this was the direction semiconductors were going, and it was going to give a tremendous cost advantage, which wasn't true at the time. The early integrated circuits cost quite a bit more than the pieces to assemble the similar circuits out of individual components. But one could see the trend was going in the direction that this was going to be the cheaper way eventually. My real objective was to get the idea across, we have a technology that's going to make electronics cheap, but I didn't expect this binary order of magnitude increase, the thousandfold increase in complexity, to be very accurate. I just thought it was a general trend we were going to have, but in fact, it was far more accurate than I could have anticipated. It was one of these articles that appeared in one of the trade magazines. You know, I wrote it as a technical paper, and one of my colleagues, I believe it was Carver Mead, a professor at Caltech, dubbed this Moore's Law, a name that has stuck beyond anything that I think could have been anticipated. It's been extended to a variety of other fields where I never would have imagined, but where things are moving exponentially or near exponentially. It has really got a lot more legs than that original paper ever had right to deserve. It's been a phenomenal technology, and it still has a ways to go.